On December 21st, the night sky lights up with a close alignment of planets Jupiter and Saturn. They're closest since the early 13th century.
What's unique about this particular one is how super close they get to each other in the sky, where they're not a degree apart, not 2 degrees apart, but just a tenth of a degree apart.
The viral buzz is that the conjunction may also be a rare glimpse of what the Star of Bethlehem may have looked like.
And so in terms of phenomena that people have used to describe that, conjunctions are one idea. There are comets, maybe.
For centuries, scientists and the faithful have looked for the origins of the star that the Bible says led magi to the place where Jesus was born in Bethlehem. German scientist Johannes Kepler, who discovered the mathematical laws of planetary motion, believed the star to be the conjunction of Jupiter, Saturn, and Venus. But star researcher Rick Larson, who's also a law professor at Texas A&M, says he found 9 distinct clues about the star in the Gospel of Matthew, including the position of the star, the motion of the star, and what the Magi said about the star.
That star was part of a very long series of events that Matthew told us about at length, but haven't been understood until recently because we couldn't recreate the skies of ancient time.
Today, with computer programs using Kepler's calculations, astronomers can rewind the celestial clock and find the exact conjunction of planets and constellations that brought about the star. However, a discrepancy over when Jesus was born led star searchers to look in 6 or 7 BC. But Larson says early documents show Jesus was born years later.
Well, then we should look in the years 2 and 3 BC for the birth of Christ and for the Star of Bethlehem. Then, when you look in those years, the sky explodes, and all of a sudden, everything Matthew says makes the fits.
Both scientists and the faithful agree the stars do tell us things, but where they disagree is on what they mean.